नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। सखेति मत्वा प्रसभं यदुक्तं हे कृष्ण हे यादव हे सखेति अजानता महिमानं तवेदं मया प्रमादात् प्ररेण वापि। ओ लॉर्ड सखेति मत्वा आई थॉट यू एज वाज योर फ्रेंड ऑफ माइन एंड आई हैव टोल्ड सो मेनी अनसिविल वर्ड्स टू यू। आई कॉल्ड यू हे कृष्णा हे यादवा हे सखा विदाउट नोइंग योर महिमा माया प्रमादात अलक्ष्यमा विदाउट नोइंग व्हाट आई एम डूइंग और आउट ऑफ फॉन्डनेस मे बी आई हैव कॉल्ड यू लाइक दिस ओ लॉर्ड बट दिस फॉर्म ऑफ योर्स दैट आई एम सीइंग इट स्ट्राइक्स टेरर इन मी आई एम टेरर स्ट्रक प्लीज विथड्रॉ दिस फॉर्म एंड कम बैक दिस सौम्य फॉर्म एज योर सॉफ्ट फॉर्म विथ फोर हैंड्स शंख चक्र गदा पाणि सौम्य फॉर्म यू कम एंड द लॉर्ड सेज ओ अर्जुना You are the most fortunate person to see this form of mine. This form of mine is the one that destroys karma, O Arjuna. Some of these explanations that I'll be telling you comes in the commentary of Jnaneshwar Maharaj in Bhavartha Deepika, Jnaneshwari, for these slokams. He says, fear not. O Arjuna, don't fear this form of me. This is the form that destroys karma. If a person sees a mountain of gold, will he run away from it, saying, I don't think I'll be able to pull it? Should a person be afraid of the sun because it creates shadows? You want to see the four-armed soft form of mine. You want the shadow and you're rejecting the substance. Almost to say, that form will not destroy karma. This is the form that destroys karma. It is foolish what you ask. Anyway, since you want to behold that form of mind, that soft form of mind, then so watch it. And he comes back and he withdraws that form in chapter 11. 54 verses this happens, and then 55th verse he gives the teaching which Adi Shankara Bhagavatpada says is the substance of Gita. 11:55. Matkarma krit mat paramo mat bhakta sanga varjita nirvaira sarva bhuteshu yama yah samameti pandava. Mat karma krit, doing my work. Mat paramo, why should he do my work? Because I am the supreme. Mat bhakta, and therefore he is my devotee. And I am the supreme, he is my devotee, he is doing all my work, and therefore sangha varjita, he has no attachment to anything else. Nirvaira sarva bhuteshu, he has no enmity towards any creature in the world. Whoever is like that, he will come to me, he says that in that 11th chapter, Vishwarupa. Darshanam. And who was seeing when all this dialogue was taking place and Vishwarupa Darshanam of Krishna Arjuna was having, there was one more person who was seeing it. Sanjaya. And Sanjaya, in the 18th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, the last chapter of Bhagavad Gita, in two consecutive verses, in the first verse he says, Rajan, to the Dhritarashtra, Rajan, Sanspritya, Sanspritya, Samvadamidam Adbhutam, Keshavardhunyo Punyam, Krishyamicha Muhur Muhu. O King, Sanspritya, Sanspritya, when I keep on remembering this dialogue, this conversation, this Bhagavad Gita, this dialogue between Keshava and Arjuna, thinking about it again and again, I am thrilled. Muhur Muhu, again and again, it thrills me to hear, think of this Bhagavad Gita dialogue. And next verse he says, तच्च संस्मृत्य संस्मृत्य रूपमत्यद्भुतं हरेः विस्मयो मे महान् राजन् हृष्यामि च पुनः पुनः. एंड रिमेंबरिंग द विश्वरूपम फॉर्म ऑफ द लॉर्ड ओ किंग अगेन एंड अगेन व्हेन आई रिमेंबर द विश्वरूपम फॉर्म ऑफ द लॉर्ड विस्मयो मे महान् राजन् हृष्यामि और अद्भुतम आई एम thrilled again and again and again. And Gyaneshwar Maharaj says, having said that, he just lapses into a mad chanting of Krishna, 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 like that. And then, these are the third last and the second last verses of Bhagavad Gita, leads to the last verse, Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna, Yatra Partho Dhanurdhara, Tatra Sri Vijayo Bhutir Dhruva Netir Matir Mama. He tells, this is my belief and faith, and I know it, O Dhritarashtra, O King. Where there is Yogeshwara Krishna, where there is the archer, Arjuna, there is Shri, glory, victory. I know it. This is my considered, deliberated opinion. Dhruva Netir Matir Mama. In the commentary to this, Gyaneshwar Maharaj says, among other things, Yatra Yogeshwara Krishna, where there is Krishna, there is victory. He is like saying like this. He says, where there is Sadguru, there will be knowledge. Where there is knowledge, there will be vision of self. Where there is vision of self, there will be contentment. All these must follow as a matter of course. Likewise, where there is Krishna, there will be Arjuna. Where there is Arjuna and Krishna, there will be Shri, Vijayo, Bhuti. This Vishwarupam form, this of Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna showed in the Sabha in Hastinapuram with the kings, Duryodhana and others, eyes closed, but with Dhritarashtra able to see, and Bhishma, Drona, Vidura, Sanjaya. Sanjaya is the person who saw it twice. Once here, once again in the battlefield. Sanspritya could also be this. The repetition, he says, I saw. In Bhasa's Dutavakyam, very famous play, in this form that Sri Krishna has taken, there is such anger that he summons the Sudarshana Chakram and tells Sudarshana Chakram, let finish the job. Let us finish the Pandava's job now. And he tells Sudarshana Chakram to go and dispatch Duryodhana. Sudarshana Chakram tells Sri Krishna, that can be done. But he reminds the Lord that if Duryodhana is killed here and now, then Sri Krishna's job will remain incomplete, which is to reduce the world of Bhubharam. So gently request him not to put him on this job. Bhagavan agrees and asks Sudarshana, okay, go back. Meanwhile, seeing Sri Krishna's intent, all his other weapons start getting invoked by themselves one after another. The Saranga Dhanush, the Kaumedika Gada, the Panchajanya Conch, the Nandana Khadgam, the sword called Nandana, the Garudan, all of them start coming, tung, ready for Sri Krishna to be dispatched. Knowing his intent, and Sudarshana stops one by one and tells him, no, Krishna is appeased now, there's no need. And they all go back. And when Krishna is appeased, he's standing there in the Sabha of Hastinapura. He withdraws his amazing Vishwarupam into himself. in Kanchipuram, not very far from the Kanchi Mat. There is one of the Divya Deshams called Pandava Dutha Perumal Kovil. Pandava Dutha Perumal Kovil is one of the 108 Divya Deshams of Sri Vaishnavas. But not many people know of it. It's not in a very well maintained outside. When you go into the temple and go to the Garbhagraham, you will be greeted with the most amazing sight of Sri Krishna and Vishwarupa. Towering at about 30 odd feet, the statue of Sri Krishna, but sitting like Dakshinamurti though, hand on. Black statue, huge statue. Pandava Dutha Perumal, Vishwarupa. Just like the Ulagalanda Perumal, Trivikrama, like that it looks, of Kanchipuram. Sri Krishna showed certain type of Vishwarupam to somebody else as well. He showed it to his mother, Yashoda. He was eating mud and he opened his mouth and showed. Now he withdrew and became himself, and Dhritarashtra, who was having divine sight, prayed to the Lord that he may take away his sight now. He had no wish to anymore to see anything else. Reminded me of an incident that I have heard from a person whose grandfather, Tanjavur, was born blind. And Paramacharya of Kanchipuram, those days when he had gone on Padayatra, that side had gone to this village as well. And something got into this old man. Something very different. He started speaking roughly to Paramacharya, saying, "What is the use of you?" kind of stuff. Something which was not, you would never have said normally, but he said. Then Mahapariva went and sat in front of him and asked for a torch to be brought and gave it. I have it asked it to be given to him. And with his hands, he said, "Let him put it on and shine it on my face." And then he asked him, "Can you see?" And he could see. And then after that, he wept and he said, "I don't want sight anymore. I have seen." Bhagavan Sri Ramana Maharshi, when he was born, a blind lady was assisting in the birth, saw a flash of supreme light, radiance everywhere. This blind man said, "Take away my eyes. I don't have any wish to see anything anymore." Thereafter, Sri Krishna took the permission of the Maharishis, saying, "I wish to leave." And taking the permission, he walked out. And as he walked out, simultaneously the Maharishis disappeared from the hall. And Sri Krishna came out. Daruka, the charioteer, was ready with the chariot. Horses ready to gallop. Ready to go away with a thunderclap. When Bhishma, Drona, Dhritarashtra, Yuyutsu, Vikarna, Kripacharya, Ashwatthama, Vidura and Vanika rushed behind Sri Krishna, when he simply walked out after taking leave of the Maharishis, he did not take leave of anybody else. They rushed behind him to see him off, but he had already gotten into the chariot with Daruka, and Daruka had taken off with a thunderclap. On that note, we will conclude today's session.